Good evening. There'll be no such thing as last drinks in many pubs across Adelaide as licensing changes are introduced to cater for World Cup soccer fans. It'll mean alcohol can be served 24 hours a day, but police are warning hooligans if they play up, they'll be kicked out.
There's nothing like a Soccer World Cup to excite the emotions of passionate fans. That concerns police, who will have to cope with thousands spilling out of pubs and clubs onto the streets. Australia's campaign kicks off at 4 a.m. next Monday, but at any time throughout the tournament, all participating venues can be open at all hours.
There's a lot of options available to police if patrons are being unruly. That includes arrest report or also bar people from those venues.
But the government says extended licences have been granted with caution. Some notorious trouble spots have been denied extra opening hours, and those which do open have to supply plenty of food and free water.
We want to make sure that fans have a really enjoyable time in a really well-managed venue.
Publicans must prove they have adequate security for their extra die-hard patrons.
It'd be in our interest to make sure that we've got control of our perimeter, particularly if we're going to be at a level that's close to capacity.
Most of these people have jobs to go to the next day, so they can't afford to be misbehaved because they've got to go to work. They can't afford to be drunk because they've got to go to work.
Mike Smithson, 7 News.
Many residents have spent the day mopping up and assessing the damage after last night's wild storms. The western suburbs were the worst hit. Several shop fronts collapsed, leaving workers in despair.
It's the end of an era for Aileen Elliott. She's run this Queenstown florist shop for 25 years, but learnt this morning that it was in ruins.
She rang me. I was still in bed. And she says, I think you better get over here. I think you've lost your front veranda.
Wild winds brought the front wall of the historic building tumbling down. The owner could be facing a damage bill up to $200,000.
It was a storm, wasn't it?
DSES responded to nearly 60 call-outs across Adelaide. At Mawson Lakes, a fallen tree downed a streetlight, while at Prospect, a large gum split in half. The Weather Bureau says a vigorous cold front drove winds up to 90 kilometres an hour.
Now that's getting towards the point at which we will issue a severe weather warning or a severe thunderstorm warning perhaps.
The metro area got up to 10 mils of rain, while up to 19 fell on the Adelaide Hills.
But the Bureau says it's been a fairly dry start to the month and we still need another 75 mils of rain to meet the monthly average.
The odd shower, I guess, persisting in the next few days, but gradually drying out, and then the next front expected in the middle of next week.
Gerda Yatsikowski, 7 News.